Well, this afternoon we're not actually talking about donations. We're not really talking about the companies involved or even the unions involved, although we've heard long lists of donations. We're talking about something much more serious. We're talking about trust. We're talking about the way that the public views us in this profession. Do they trust us to do the right thing? Do they trust us in our interactions with companies, in our interactions in handing out contracts, to be objective? To be objective about our dealings with which company is the right company to deal with, to be objective in the development of policy, and to be subjective in a different way. To be subject to our commitment to serve the needs of the people of this province, Mr. Speaker, because it is really important that we maintain what is our primary goal. Our primary goal is not to help any particular business or any particular company. Our primary goal is to achieve the best for the people of this province. And I always go back to the way we define that the most clearly, which is the best health outcomes. I reference that in particular because there's some pretty important lessons for us from the health field. Mr. Speaker, as you well know, prior to being in this work, I was practicing as a family physician. And in that field, in the field of medicine, there's a long-standing practice whereby pharmaceutical companies have the practice of giving gifts to physicians. And sometimes those are simple things like a pen or a mug, a pad of paper,
socks. Or
it could be a pair of socks, or it could be something bigger, a golf trip, a fancy dinner, or something even bigger like payments directly to that physician for prescribing the drug in question. What's clear is that the greater the degree of connection, the greater the degree of gift, greater the size of the gift, the greater the influence. But it doesn't actually have to be that big of a gift. Even just that pen, that pad of paper, the logo on an anatomy poster, that influences, studies have shown very clearly, that influences behavior. That affects the decisions they do, and of course it does. That's why they do it. Mr. Speaker, the pharmaceutical companies aren't giving doctors mugs because they want them to have a good hot cup of coffee. It's because they want them to prescribe their drugs. And the same is true. The same is true for Crescent Point, the same is true for Synovus, the same is true for Encana, the same is true for any of the companies that are giving money to the Sask Party. They're not doing it because they believe in the beautiful vision of this cabinet. They're not. They're doing it because they believe that that will influence their opportunities. The donors, the reason that donors give money to your party, the reason that people that give money to, absolutely, I say it for clear, and I'll say it again. And the same is true for donors to political companies, political parties. There's no reason that these companies would give these large amounts if they didn't want to have some influence over your behavior and your thinking. Now, Mr. Speaker, this is a practice that has been investigated quite seriously within the medical profession, and there's been efforts to root that out. They've been expected to root this out. And we've seen a big movement in the right direction, where we no longer have those golf trips and other things being allowed in that profession. And certainly it's something that I've avoided doing myself. I've avoided having those discussions with pharmaceutical companies in my office. And Mr. Speaker, that's in one of the most trusted professions. Physicians are up there with the pharmacists and the firemen for the most trusted professions. You know who isn't among those most trusted professions? Politicians. And there's a good reason for that. Physicians realize that trust is our greatest asset with the public and with our patients. If we want our patients to actually take our advice and change their behavior, we need to have their solid trust. We need to have no indication of any influence, any outside influence. Mr. Speaker, I'm concerned I might have hit a little too close to home here, but the reality is that we want to be trusted as a profession. We want people to look at us as political leaders and be able to trust that we're not being influenced. And there's a reality. The studies show it very clearly. The members across are very upset about this description, but the reality is you can't avoid. The psychology is real. You can't avoid being influenced by who donates to your party. You won't be. And even if you could set up this perfect barrier that preserves you from any influence from the people who donate to you, the public would still think that the influence is there. Whatever the reality is, the perception is very clear, Mr. Speaker. Even if you could make that barrier, the public doesn't trust this profession and they don't trust it for some very clear reasons. What are those reasons? We have public institutions. We have universities, libraries donating to political parties. We have big gala dinners where people pay extra money to have closer access to members of the government. Mr. Speaker, we have, up until a very recent past, big dollars, you know, up to $500,000 in the last decade, of top-ups to the Premier's salary directly connected to those donations. Mr. Speaker, we have contracts. We see in today's motion, and today's motion is driven by the realization that people who donated $1 million, 53 companies who donated $1 million to the Saskatchewan Party wound up with $100 million in contracts. Mr. Speaker, whether that was influenced or not, the perception is there, and the trust of our profession is damaged by that. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. It does seem unusual to have had to sit down three times in a 10-minute speech. I expect we're getting a bit too close to home because the public knows about this. 81% of the Saskatchewan public says no public institutions should be able to contribute to political parties. 69% said we shouldn't have out-of-province donations, and 74% said no money from charities. But this party persists in insisting that that behavior is absolutely fine, despite the fact that it is damaging our reputation as a profession, Mr. Speaker. When this happens, when we see this happening, people stop seeing us differently, and I wish you would listen, because this is really important. This is about you and me. It's about all of us. When people look at this house and they say you're in there for money and power, when they say that you're in there and you're influenced by big corporations, it cheapens all of our work, and this work is important, and it distresses me no end to see this sort of a resistance to even a consideration of the way we present ourselves, to see the party across the way point fingers and say, well, you do the same things, you take money from unions, you take money from companies. Do you think the public looks at us and says, oh, they're pointing fingers and say, you did it too, or you started it? What mature people? Oh, we can really trust them even more? Of course they don't. Mr. Speaker, this cheapens our very work. When the Premier doubles down on this practice, when he further entrenches the idea that we are all in this for money and power, he cheapens the work of every one of us. Mr. Speaker, when you have this kind of activity, it hurts the reputation of the province and of the profession. And Mr. Speaker, Alan Blakely described this as a noble calling, and I fully believe that it is. I fully believe. I had some members across there shouting, saying that I was indicating they were bought and sold. Absolutely not. I know that you're in here for good reasons. Every one of us is in here for reasons of decency. But Mr. Speaker, this sort of behavior makes it look like it's the opposite. Makes it look like we're in here for money and power. And that's why this needs to be changed. Mr. Speaker, we need to get off this drug. We need to get out from under the influence and catch up with the rest of the country. Everyone else in the country, with the exception of BC, and we may very soon see them head in a similar direction, has been limiting corporate and union donations, has been moving away from this direction. So that's what we need to do, Mr. Speaker. We need to enact this motion and stop having any connection between corporations that lobby or donate and contracts. We need to ban corporate and union donations. We need to set a reasonable personal limit so we don't have individuals with outsized influence and outsized ability to contribute to who wins government. We need to absolutely eliminate out-of-province charity and public institution donations. And we need to have a good look at the internal party finances as well. And in the process, Mr. Speaker, we have an opportunity. We have an opportunity that I really wish, I know my members will embrace, and I really wish the members across would embrace as well. But we have an opportunity to restore trust, and perceived influence of corporate donations, the corrupt reputation and the actions of this House, Mr. Speaker. And that's why I'm happy to support this motion and happy to support any motion that removes this greater influence of corporations and wealthy individuals on our public process. Thank you so much.